So let's put it all together, the mechanisms that exokernel offers and how library operating systems can live on top of this red line, that is the protection boundary for exokernel, and meaningfully execute applications that belong to it on the hardware resources and not interfere with one another. That is, achieve both extensibility, protection, and performance. So one of the hooks for getting good performance is what I mentioned earlier, and that is code that are performance critical for a library operating system is something that can be downloaded securely into the exokernel so that that piece of code becomes sort of the extension of exokernel for a particular library operating system. This may be for OS 1, this may be for OS 2, and so on and so forth. So now, with this setup, at any point of time, some application process of some library operating system is running on the CPU. Now, remember that exokernel has no idea about processes within any of these library operating systems. All it knows is existence of these library operating systems and the fact that exokernel has been the broker in giving some hardware resources, capabilities for some hardware resources, I should say, to specific library operating systems. And it has also been the broker for downloading some code specific to library operating systems into the exokernel code base itself. Let's say that this particular thread belongs to this library operating system. As long as this thread is well behaved, by which I mean it's not doing anything funky, doing normal program execution, accessing memory for which mappings exist in the TLB and so on, life is good, address translation happens on every memory access entirely in the CPU, and the process is making forward progress at memory speeds without intervention from exokernel or any other library operating system. But there could be discontinuities in the execution of this process. For example, let's say that this process or thread makes a system call, like opening a file. When it does that, that is a discontinuity in the normal execution of this process. Or worse yet, it may incur a page fault, meaning that not all of the pages for this particular process is currently in the mapping available to the hardware in the TLB, and therefore there's a page fault. Even worse, this thread could do something stupid, such as divide by zero or something like that, that causes an exception. And lastly, the thread is not doing anything to cause the discontinuity, but there is an external interrupt that came in, and that is going to cause a discontinuity to this execution of this process on the CPU. All such discontinuities essentially result in the CPU incurring a fault or a trap, and the trap is fielded by exokernel. When such discontinuities occur, exokernel has to pass the program discontinuity to the appropriate library operating system that is living on top of it. Now, exokernel knows, based on the linear vector of time slots that I mentioned earlier, which library operating system is currently running on the CPU. And therefore, it knows the right library operating system to which it has to pass the discontinuity that occurred right now for the currently executing process. To facilitate a finer-grained association between these different kinds of discontinuities and the specific functionality in the library operating system for dealing with those discontinuities, exokernel maintains state for each currently executing library operating system. And we will discuss the state maintained by exokernel on behalf of every library operating system next.